Daniel Saman joins us now. He's the chief epidemiologist at HealthWatch USA. And Dr. Saman, thanks for coming in this morning.
Thank you very much.
First question, you know, the 48 people who had contact with Thomas Eric Duncan before he was admitted, their 21 days of the incubation period, as it's called, ends today. If they get to tomorrow without any symptoms, are they 100% really in the clear now?
Well, the CDC and World Health Organization tell us that, you know, after that point, that for the most part, you're in the clear. So, generally speaking, yes.
Okay. You know, there have been some questions about funding, if there were more money for the CDC, if there were even a Surgeon General, is that this would be, that we would be in a different situation. Do you see that this could be improved by CDC funding? If you had the Surgeon General voice, do you think we'd be in a different position?
You know, there's been a cut in funding for the CDC and for NIH. And if you want to have organizations that are prepared to fight this type of battle, you're going to have to up the funding. That's critical. It's critical that we have those organizations in place and are well funded year after year. And if they're not, they're not going to be prepared.
So let's talk about the response from the CDC, also from state agencies, even the hospital. As we kind of grade what's happened over the last couple of weeks, how do you grade their response thus far?
Well, that's a difficult question to answer. I think that they can always be doing better. And they're looking, they're doing investigations right now about what could be done better in the Dallas hospital. So it's hard for me to answer that type of question.
So, okay, let's look forward then.
Sure.
Flu season is coming, and you will have people who have fevers and body aches, and there will be the confusion, what exactly do I have? Mm-hmm. How do you expect that they will respond, or have you seen any indication of a plan to respond when you have so many people who have the symptoms of this killer virus?
Mm-hmm. You're right, some of the symptoms are going to cross over. But if you haven't been exposed to somebody, if you're not a caretaker of someone that has Ebola, if you're not in direct contact with bodily fluids, you are most likely not going to have Ebola.
What's the impact of this new, as he's called, Ebola czar, do you think?
I don't know. It's way too early to judge that. He was just named by President Obama a few days ago.
What would you hope his impact would be?
I would hope his impact would be to relay an effective message and to kind of push the agenda forward that this needs to stop now. We need to have a galvanized international response. No longer can Doctors Without Borders alone go after this epidemic. If we have a galvanized response, then we can stop this epidemic.
All right, Dr. Daniel Saman, thank you so much for offering your insight this morning.
Thank you.